Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today we study cathode rays and discovery of electron, class 9, chapter number 2. Actually, lot of experiments performed to discover the electrons, but in 1879, Sir William Crookes performed experiment by passing the electric current through the gas in the discharge tube to discover the electrons. First of all, we look the experiment. Sir William Crookes took a test tube which have two electrodes, cathode and anode. Inside the test tube, the atmosphere is adjusted with a vacuum pump and the pressure is kept 10 raised minus 4 atmosphere. When these two electrodes, cathode and anode, connected with a high voltage battery, the current pass through the gas and the rays is produced from the cathode travel toward the anode. He called these rays as cathode rays. After the discovery of cathode rays, some properties and characteristics are also mentioned, which we discuss here. Number one, these rays travel in straight line perpendicular to the cathode surface toward the anode. Once again, these rays travel in straight line perpendicular to the cathode surface. Second, these rays cast a sharp shadow of an opaque object if placed in their path. If any object is placed in the path of these rays, then these rays create the sharp shadow of that object. Number three, they are negatively charged. In electric and magnetic field, the deflection of these rays toward the positive plate indicated that they are negatively charged. Once again, the deflection of these rays in electric and magnetic field proved toward the positive plate proved that they are negatively charged. Number four, cathode rays raise the temperature of the body on which they fall. It means if any body is used on which these rays are fall, the temperature of the body will increase. Number five, J.J. Thomson discovered the charge over mass ratio of these rays. J.J. Thomson discovered the charge over mass ratio of these rays. Number six, these rays produce light when these rays hits the walls of the discharge tubes. Means when these rays hit the wall of the discharge tube, these rays produce light. Number seven, same rays are emitted. There is no matter which type of gas is present in the discharge tube and which kind of electrode, means cathode and anode, are made of. Either matter is used for cathode and anode or any gas is used in the discharge tube, these rays will surely emit it. So these are the few properties and characteristics of the cathode rays. Now, on the basis of these characteristics or properties, some explanation is also here. Number one, nature of cathode rays is independent. Nature of cathode rays is independent to which gas used in the discharge tube and the cathode and anode. Means the nature of cathode rays never dependent on the gas used in the discharge tube and the electrodes. Number two, these are fast moving particles. The characteristics which mention that these rays cast a sharp shadow of an opaque object if placed in their path indicated that these are not the rays. Actually, these are the fast moving particles. Number three, all materials produce same type of particles. All materials contain electrons. It means that we mentioned earlier that the nature of these rays not depend on the gas present in the discharge tube and the electrodes. So it means all type of gases produce the same type of particles. So we can say that electrons are the fundamental particle of atom. So dear students, today's homework is cathode rays and characteristics. Learn by heart. Thank you.